We're going to step up as 21st century warriors, and we're going to help dreams for the future come true. So I'm really happy to stand here before you guys. I'm going to smudge the foundation, and then I'm going to smudge everybody here.
Like his ancestor, Chief Red Cloud, Henry is also waging war, but on a different front. His is a battle to build a better future for his people.
Here within the homeland, we need 4,000 homes today. Within a four-bedroom house, there'll be, 30 people. As you ride across Indian country here, you see a lot of 1970 mobile homes. Two-inch thick wall and not too much insulation, pretty much a tin box. It gets brutally cold here. This past winter, we had a minus 26 air temp. The wind began to blow, and then it took it to minus 40. It's not a surprise to hear somebody freezing to death. We're gonna put it up Lakota style. We're gonna put up this tipi structure that way. Two poles on the east side laying out towards the south, and then two on the west side. Gonna bring the tips together. We'll tie it there. Then the rest of us will walk it up. Okay, that's not going anywhere.
All right.
Let's do it.
The poles, based on a traditional tipi, formed the structure to lift into place an entirely new kind of home.
Back up a little bit, just straight back at him. Go ahead, set it down there.
Henry's mission is a magnet that attracts innovative builders, Aaron Resnick and Jason Mackey.
Initially, Henry asked us when we came out here to the reservation the first time and we saw the housing problem. He said, I need something that someone can survive the winter in for less than $20,000.
All right.
I like it.
So we said, okay, we'll try, but that sounds like a challenge.
We sat down one evening to look at what would be the best here, low cost with high efficiency, and they came up with this new technique, foamcrete.
There is a pretty unique material. It's called cellular concrete, or on the internet, it's often called foamcrete or aircrete.
It's 80% air, just full of all these little bubbles. And so that's the property that makes it super, super insulating. So, you can survive minus 40 degree temperatures.
We built two in the past. We built one, failed on us, but lessons learned. So we went back to the drawing board. And then we built one last year.
Henry's first shot failed. The second stood, but was too small. As his latest design begins to take shape, he remains convinced this home could transform not only Pine Ridge, but many Native communities across Indian country.
The structure is taking the old way of the teepee and then incorporating it within this foamcrete. It actually looks like a teepee. Okay, we're gonna go face the door east as our ancestors did when they camped. So let me see here. Let me pull up my old Indian trick. Everybody carried one of these back in the day. We're gonna be able to step out, greet that morning sun, and then we'll have a walking path into the food right here. Awesome.
Ho choka el oyate ki wa kha wa e chumpi.